This is another music production for beginners question that comes up quite often. 32 or 64-bit VST plugins, what should you get? I'm Zane, welcome to Simple Green Tech, where I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. Now, to answer the 64-bit plugins versus 32-bit question, you need to know what your DAW is. Are you running a 64-bit DAW or a 32-bit DAW, also known as a digital audio workstation? And this is your music-making software. And to find out if your DAW is 32 or 64-bit, you can head over to their website and it should tell you on there. But some DAWs still come in either 32-bit or 64-bit, so you'll have to find out which one you downloaded and installed. But most modern digital audio workstations are 64-bit now. And once you figure out what your music making software is, then download the VST plugin that is the same. So if you're running a 32-bit DAW, download 32-bit plugins. If you're running a 64-bit DAW, download 64-bit plugins. However, there are some 64-bit DAWs that have a 32-bit bridge in them, so you can still install 32-bit plugins and use them, but I found that those can be a little buggy when trying to use them, so if there is a 64-bit version of the plugin that you want to use, install that one and you won't have to worry about that bugginess. Only use those 32-bit bridges if you absolutely must. Now, if you're still looking for music making software that suits your needs, you can click up here to check out some of the best free digital audio workstations available, or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane, keep creating, and we'll talk soon.